I think this is probably one of the most significant experiences that I've had.
Until you're here, you see it for yourself, and seeing really is believing.
The effect of the flood in so many different ways across such a huge area, we have no perception of the scale of it.
Notice there are tents around the perimeter, and basically they're waiting for aid, they're waiting for support, and hopefully today that support has arrived. With
Hi, I'm Mo Chowdhury. I suppose Secret Millionaire fame. I'm now in Pakistan. I've been invited by Prince Charles's program, Seeing and Believing. The purpose is to actually go and visit the affected areas after the floods and see how it's impacted and whether the reconstruction is happening. If so, how it is happening, and if not, what can we do about it? At the Pakistan end of it, it's in collaboration with the James Khan Foundation, because James Khan Foundation have already made a commitment to source a village. I think they've shortlisted 2 or 3 villages, so we will actually be going along with that team to look at and visit those villages, and then in terms of which visit is selected to be the first for reconstruction. We've seen some destruction. We've seen villages have been totally destroyed. The first one, mud up to waist high. I see some quite a positive output so far, because I can see construction happening. You know, it's all right having these dreams and people thinking and talking about it, but actually coming at the sharp end and doing it and seeing construction happening as with your own eyes, it makes a significant difference. That's probably been the most shocking moment for me, really, to actually ask them to find out what they got. No family, there's no welfare system in this country, there are no children, and most people depend on the children and grandchildren. Who's going to fend for them, you know? It's just it's devastating.
For all the generosity that's come so far, there is still so much that still needs to be done.
The cause of these people, the plight of these people, is absolutely critical. They truly need our help. The funds that have been raised so far, what they've really done is they've provided food and water. What they haven't got is a home to live in. Unless we can give them back their dignity and their livelihoods, the plight of these people will be devastating, not just for today, but for years to come.
And I think one of the ways is to try and ensure that people understand where their money is going. That it's going into credible organisations. Today we're visiting Islamic Relief. It's fantastic work in villages, a great reputation, and you can actually come out here and see what's going on.
Anything that you can do to help the James Khan Foundation, to help build villages, to give life back to these people and give dignity back to these people, you will be making a difference. You will be changing somebody's lives. So please, help and support. We need your help.
But it was a shock. It was a shock. Despite the fact that I was kind of braced myself for the effect of it, still a shock. There's massive destruction on an unprecedented scale, and we see it, and you can feel it, you can smell it, you can just sense it, and it is overwhelming. So I go back with a new resolve to try and do my bit if I can. But in this film that we produce and develop, will go a long way towards actually bringing to life, you know, what actually has been happening, and actually making it more tangible and real, so you can really feel the effect of it, and hopefully. We can all do a little bit to make a little bit of a difference to people.